Now, with regards to old folks' home, they've been infected. So we look into our data. So far, we have 21 clusters related to the old folks' home, 2 during the second wave, and 19 the third wave. We have been, so we have 19 clusters at the moment. And out of the 19, 15 still active, and 6 have ended. So we look into the numbers so far. There's been infected 610 cases involving 583 Malaysian. That is equivalent to 95.6%, and 27 cases of 4.4% non-Malaysian. And the total number screened so far for in the old folks home 1,840 individuals. And a post, and the fatality rate 1.48, slightly higher than the national fatality rate of 0.38. And 9 cases, we have 9 cases of fatality been documented so far. So what we have to do is one of the strategy in our public health measures. We have 6 strategy. One is the border control. Second, to make sure the health facilities, hospitals, are able to accommodate patients and also the ICU beds. And third, we are looking into public health measures to contain and the infection, to contact tracing and etc. Fourth is to protect the vulnerable group. And fifth, we are looking into strategic communication, and last but not least is public empowerment. So the fourth strategy is basically to protect the vulnerable group. So what we have done is that we have stepped up in terms of the SOP. We have an SOP for old folks' home. Make sure that the compliance with SOP is important. Second is that we have put on hold any physical gathering activities in the old folks' home. And the Ministry of Health provide periodic assessment and screening in the old folks' home as well. And more importantly is that we need to protect this vulnerable population. I think this is follow the SOP and make sure that there's no face-to-face engagement. You know, in terms of visitors coming in, and they have to comply to all SOPs as what we have been doing. I think that is the key. So the compliance of SOP is very important for us to break the chain of COVID infection in our country.